Good afternoon, everyone. We are here to represent the Vodafone case of Vodafone International Company, which is noted under the case number 26629 of the company. I'll talk about the introduction and the background of the case. There was an HTL company which was operating in Hong Kong. The company was controlling the Hudson Essa company, which was operating in India, and was holding a 67% of it. But it was controlling through a joint venture, so it means the HTL company was controlling indirectly the Indian company. And the company, which was called CGP, which was an investment company which was operating in Mauritius. And that company was being holded by HTL company 100% shareholding. So what happened in December 2006, Vodafone announced HTL announced that there is some potential investors which need to come and buy some shares, equal share of Hutch Essa Group Indian company. Then after that, Vodafone came out with a bid that they will buy the company with a higher price. The HTL company accepted, and on February 2007, it accepted and announced officially that Vodafone is controlling the Indian group company. What happened is Vodafone tried to follow the procedures by going to FPBI of India, the Foreign Investment Body of India, to get the permission of controlling an Indian company. But the business was between the two foreign countries, which was Hong Kong and UK. So the foreign FBI, they have been wondering why you are doing this. Then the Vodafone said, because there are some other group joint venture people who are controlling the Asia group. So I have to ask the permission from them so that I can be able to control the all 67%. The FBI was not having any problem with that. Just told the Vodafone to pay some amount of money so that to acquire the remaining 15% of shares so as to reach the exactly 67%. I'll pass by Gopi for the transactions.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'll be doing the transaction that happened between Cayman Islands, Air Company, and Hutchinson. The Cayman Islands had acquired 67% in Hutchinson Air. Hutchinson has sold Cayman Islands to Vodafone at $10 million in 2007 without deducting any TDS. Over to Charlie. Good afternoon. I would be like talking upon the impact of the case. Directly, there was no tax implication in India for such transaction. As per Indian tax law, this transaction was not taxable in India because both the companies, they were non-resident of India, and the company sold was also a foreign company, which was Cayman Island. Issues related to implication of payment of TDS. In case of issue, a certificate from chartered accountant is required. However, it is recommended that if a chartered accountant has any doubt, you should take the opinion from the CIT. But in this case, CIT's opinion was not taken. Indirectly, the controlling interest of Hutchinson Essa has been sold through this transaction. Because Cayman Islands was only a paper company which has no value in itself without controlling interest in Hutchinson Essa, which is an Indian company. Hutchinson has sold shares of Indian company in form of Cayman Islands. But by this method, they have saved capital gain taxes out to be arisen in India on such transaction. I would be calling Suki.
The actual game begins when the Income Tax Department issues a show cause notice to the Vodafone imposing penalty for the non-deduction of TDS while making payment to the Hong Kong company. Vodafone, instead of replying to the show cause notice, they file a writ petition to challenge the jurisdiction of the Income Tax Department in the Mumbai High Court. So, Mumbai High Court, after learning about the case, they reject the petition with the cost. So Vodafone is not happy with the rejection, so they go and file an SLP in the Supreme High Court. And SLP is filed when you are not happy with the state High Court decision verdict. So Vodafone files an SLP in the Supreme High Court. Supreme High Court transfers the whole case to the Income Tax Department with specific instructions to examine the facts and determine whether the Income Tax Department had the jurisdiction to issue a show cause notice to the Vodafone. Now, and the Supreme Court also makes sure that it asks the Vodafone to appear before the Income Tax Department whenever required. And the court also makes it very clear that the Income Tax Department cannot pass any order for penalty because the Supreme Court is the one who decides the main matter of the tax dispute. This is where the whole case takes a turn, but there are some more other interesting facts regarding the case which will be explained by Shakuntala and Amrita.
Good afternoon, everyone. Here are some interesting facts about the case. Acheson is still not a party of any proceeding, and law is amended that retrospectively to stop tax evasion. And the assisting officer who has opened this case has currently become the chief commissioner of IT department, and the IT department has opened 50 similar cases like this. And the revenue department is embroiled in a legal battle with US-based General Electric for its 60% stake in Genpact. Stake was sold for $500 million. For getting required approvals from international bodies in all applications and even in letters to shareholders, Acheson Armstrong and Vodafone are told that they are seeking permission to transaction of shares in Indian company. They did not mention the Acheson SR company anywhere. Thank you. Over to you.
They have taken alternative for tax evasion also. As per Indian Mauritius tax treaty, capital gain arises from transfer of shares of Indian company being held by Mauritian company cannot be taxed in India. Assume if Cayman Island could have been sold shares held in Indian company directly to the Vodafone, then also capital gain arising from this transaction cannot be taxed in India as per DTA provision. Few countries like USA did not sign any DTA provisions with the countries having tax haven kind of law, just to avoid these type of transactions. Acheson is liable to pay the capital gain tax. Capital gain tax because there is no DTA between Indian and Hong Kong company. But still, Acheson is out of purview for all legal proceedings. Harisar is appearing for Vodafone before Supreme Court. There are three grounds under consideration in this case. They are lifting of corporate waste, transfer of underlying assets, and relinquishment of rights. After considering all these other facts, there are some questions which are still unanswered. Does asking a non-resident to comply with Indian legal procedures amount to extraterritorial jurisdiction? Can a company merely having an incorporate certificate of tax evasion, tax haven country and a few files in its office should be allowed to evade taxes by various methods? Can any company relief as per DTA provision even after making defaults? If Income Tax Department is allowed to pass protective assessment order, why not SSC can make protective claims? Over to
thank you, Amrita. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, friends. I'm here to give some updates in the case. It started on 15 November 2010, the disputes relating with Vodafone. The tax office had asked the Vodafone to deposit $550 million within three weeks in relation to $2.5 billion as tax dispute. So tax office had also asked Vodafone to pay $2.5 billion and also asked them to make some bank guarantee worth of $1.5 billion within 8 weeks. Now, under Section 9 of the Income Tax Act says or defines that income deemed to accrue or arise in India. They say on what happened on 4th August was that the Vodafone said that, or it wasn't, they mean to say, even the Indian firms which pay their dividends outside India are non-transferable under the Act. So the Vodafone said that when such things are not mentioned, any such transfers of control to be taxed. On 5th August 2011, Vodafone told, until and unless the Parliament makes such kind of rules and regulations to impose capital gain tax on such details. They said that Vodafone told the Supreme Court that the Revenue Department cannot impose them rupees 11,000 crores tax relating to its acquisition of Hutchison Limited Indian operation. What they mean to say, until the Parliament does not give such kind of rules, and they cannot impose such kind of rules, regulation as such. And lastly, on 13th September 2011, Vodafone has paid rupees 3,900 crores tax under protest. This was all about the updates in the case. Now I will request my friend Saraswati to come over here and explain certain judgments. Thank you.
I am here to explain about the judgment given by the Mumbai High Court and the Supreme Court. Mumbai High Court judgment asked the Vodafone to pay the income tax of 11,000 crores as income tax, but in the Supreme Court, the Supreme Court set aside the Mumbai judgment and about the Vodafone paying 11,000 crores as the income tax to the IT department. The Supreme Court also asked the Vodafone, the IT department to return the 2,500 crores deposited by the Vodafone along with the 4% interest within the 2 months of period.
Good afternoon, everyone. The legal opinion about the case. The government has no jurisdiction over Vodafone purchase of mobile assets in India, since all companies, sellers and purchase companies were outside India. From that, the government of India has no jurisdiction over Vodafone. This is all said by S.H. Kapadia, Chief Justice of India. The Income Tax Department can file a review petition on the Supreme Court's judgment. This is because even if the Supreme Court has decided, everyone is not convinced about this case. Means some they are saying this case was resolved in order to continue attracting some investment from outside of India. Thank you.